Hello everyone, this is Direwolf20, and welcome to episode 30 of Direwolf20's Space Engineers series. I'm retrofitting my old and junky kind of grinder ship. It's not really junky, but remember I destroyed my welder ship last episode, because I'm a derp. I don't even know how I did it, to be honest with you. I think I flew into something by mistake. And I've now just retrofitted my grinder ship that I had into a welder ship. All it really took was, you know, renaming the cargo container so that would suck up all the inventory that I had on my base, which probably means that my base is currently working on crafting new things for me, which would be super. What am I working on today? I don't know. There's a couple things I wouldn't mind taking a look at. But first, let's just go make sure that things are running. Oh good, they are. Nice. Yeah, you can see all the resources rebuilding themselves as a result of, you know, everything being running and whatnot. We're still pretty good on resources, which is nice. Although I do want to check what's up with Nakuta. Is that in the refineries? Yeah, there's like one little bit of Nakuta here. I don't know what's up with that, but it's like lingering. And are we like not sure what to do with certain things? Cool. Alright, you are pretty darn full. Large ingot P4. As are you. Wow. I guess I had a lot of ingots. I guess my best bet is to go weld up another ingot storage unit. I was not prepared for that. Maybe Nakuta is pretty heavy. I don't know. I think these two are the ones that have been storing ingots for me. Yeah, so let's throw another one here. I'm going to weld this up. You know what? Let's grab our welder ship to do it. Because that would just be a good idea. I hear all this stuff running in here. Excellent. Didn't I have a door here? Thought I did, but I must not have. Well, there's a door there now. I'll fix that later. Flew all the way over there, I had to do something, right? I should really put a few more doors throughout my base so that it's easier for me to get outside when I decide I want to. But I have a cool idea for something I want to work on. It's just going to be, will it be doable? Alright, let's put our block group toggle block on off. All right, platform. It's probably just named large, and it should be this one. So I'm gonna make this ingot P5. Cool. Oh, wait a minute. He may not be connected to anything. Yes, that is probably true. All right, let me fix that real quick. There we go. That should fix things up rather nicely. And platform, inventory, ingot P5. Perfect. Nice. Wow. What is it? Oh, it's gravel? I guess it's gravel that's taking up just a ridiculous amount of storage space. There must just be a ton of stone in there somewhere. That's all I can imagine. Let's doing that. Let's change these larges as well. I'm gonna make this ingot P6 along here somewhere as well. Just so we don't have competing inventories. Okay, that should do. All right, I have a plan. Let's go check out something. So last episode, we had a little bit of fun, didn't we? I think we did. We made a Stargate. Ah, it was very cool. And I had a good time making it. Let's pop through. There we go. Nice. So we can see it looks like it's just about sunrise. Right, obviously no jetpack ability on the planet here. Wish I had some way to automatically turn off my jetpack. That would kind of be cool. Oh, what happened to this ship? Don't tell me he ran out of fuel or something. He definitely seems to be running, but it's like... interesting. He, like, fell. Oh, well. I'm not going to worry about him too much. Ooh, that reminds me. Do I have any hydrogen on me? I should probably try and grab some. Because I need to make sure I've got gravity back at the base. Because once gravity's off, we're like kind of stuck and immobile. But luckily grabbing hydrogen allows me to turn my jetpack on and we're good. Let's see what we can do here. All right, I'm going to make sure that we have a gravity generator right here near this thing. And I'm going to adjust the field width so that it's pretty narrow. Let's do... gravity generator, I guess, here too. Looking for the control panel on the thing. There it is. Yep, gravity generator 2. So we'll just bring the field height down to about 20. What I'm going to do is show on HUD, and we will show gravity range and sensors range. That's fine. Gravity is the one that we're going to really care about. Width we'll bring down to about 30, and depth we'll bring down to about 30. And we'll see if we can see the range on this thing. Oh, yeah, I can kind of see it there. Again, probably not too well for YouTube, unfortunately, but we'll see what we can do. We'll bump that up to... height can stay at 20. We'll bump these out to like 50 meters each. This will just ensure that we're covered all around the platform here. I can barely see it. Let me know in comments. Like, I'm curious how well you guys can see this. It's really hard to detect for me. So it's gotta be hard to detect for you guys. But yeah, you can definitely see the gravitational pull there. So I might want to pull back on the gravity a little bit, but it's all right. What I'll probably do is make it like a third. Yeah, if we made it like 0.3G, that's fine to walk around in. But in the area that overlaps, it's really just 1G. That's cool. That'll work. Probably just shrink it a little bit. All right, that didn't change at all. So that means the one I'm looking for is... depth. We'll bring that down to 37. Yeah, see? Just a small area where it's a little bit high. That's fine. Cool. The next thing I'd like to do, I think I'd like to visit the other planet that exists in the system. That guy. He looks kind of cool, doesn't he? I think, again, how do I want to do this? I might want to... build a ship that we can send over there, land on the planet, and maybe even turn into a base on the planet. Does that sound like kind of a neat idea? That might not be terrible, right? Or maybe I should bring this ship that I'm in, but I really wouldn't like to lose it. You know what I'll do? Is I'll make a new one of these ships that I'm in, and then bring it over to the planet. And if I lose it, oh well. That's like a plan? I think that's a cool idea. All right, let's do that. I will be back in a minute. Or you know what? I can probably just platform the projector that's there. We're going to do the blueprint of large welder. Cool. And we'll grab our small light armor blocks there. Hopefully I can sneak these guys onto here. I don't have any steel plates on me. I should really modify the blueprint here so that the tube system that controls all the inventory hooks into the cockpit, but that's okay. For now, I'm gonna hold off on doing that, but maybe I'll do that soon. I think I'm working towards an idea of a new idea for something I want to build. All right, that looks good. So, back in a few minutes. All right, guys, I think she's done. Nice. Just making sure the last finishing touches are on her. That'll do. Perfect. Let's grab... I should really have, like, a cargo container available out here so I can grab stuff as needed, but something I'll work on later. I would like to go explore that alien planet. So first, let's grab from here some uranium. About 100 ought to do, maybe 200. I'm gonna make sure I've got a decent amount in the ship here. And before, remember, we detach it from the base, we wanna make sure. And the connector here. Is there really only one of these? Okay, cool. Uranium 25, you can convey our system off. Cool. Guess the rest went into... Oh, it all went into the... Cool. I know what's happening. I'm just getting confused. Let's disconnect it from the base so that we don't get confused. Ah, that's why. Oh, some of them didn't get finished. Oh well, that's no big deal. I can finish them later. The shield gen didn't get finished either. Let me take care of that briefly. Alright guys, I think I'm ready for my trip. So what I'm gonna do, believe it or not, is fly the existing ship out there. So this ship is empty, and he's just chilling here, doing his thing, right? Everything's working beautifully. I'm gonna grab the extra 100 uranium that I had on there, and I think I'm gonna go fly out to that alien planet and see what it's all about. Nice. So let's bring that with me. I'm gonna throw it into the inventory here. We'll just put you in the cargo container. That's fine. Along with the oxygen and hydrogen bottles. You know what? I'll keep the steel plates in my inventory. Let's go make a trek out there. Now, double checking that I've got Nakuta. Good. That's enough to build a Stargate on that planet. So it's a weird purplish color, which makes me even more interested in checking it out. So let's build up some speed here. Hopefully we can get up to a decent amount. So there's two planets, actually. There's that one, which is like a reddish color and definitely appears to have like a moon of some kind. Kind of cool. And then that weird purpley looking one. Kind of want to check out that weird one, don't you guys? I'm not sure how far away it is, but we'll find out soon. So I'll come back in a minute. I've probably got a little bit of traveling to do. So guys, I just traveled 40,000 kilometers. And that planet looks no closer than it did a minute ago. So I'm really not quite sure how far away it is. I'm thinking jump drive time. All right, guys, looks like my jump drive here is almost fully charged, which means we should be able to make our blind jump in just a moment, or more accurately, in just about 10 seconds. I think I'm gonna aim for that reddish planet first. Really not quite too sure how far I need to jump. So I'm gonna make a blind jump, let's see. Fully charged, nice. Max jump distance is 2,000 kilometers. Perfect. Let's jump. Yes. And we'll see how close we get at 2,000 kilometers. It takes about 5 or 6 minutes to fully charge the jump drive. Hopefully, it gets us reasonably close or past. Past will work. Oh, hello. How's it going? I went just past it. That is awesome. Yeah, we are 2 million meters away, so that's pretty cool. You can see, obviously, the jump drive needs to recharge before we can get back. But I would like to check out this planet. What do you guys say? I don't know how far away I am from said planet, because planets are big. It looks like I'm not really even getting closer at all, doesn't it? I definitely am, but it just looks like I'm not. So, wow. I am really far away from my base right now. That is so cool. This almost looks like Mars, doesn't it? It's like really reddish and stuff. I wonder what kind of ores I'd find on this planet. Alright, let's give this thing a minute or two and we'll be right back. I'm going to fly towards the planet and see. Once I get into the range of the planet, maybe I'll build an outpost here. And then this will be a good place to kind of establish our first base. And then we'll go check out that purplish planet in the distance in a bit. And I also wouldn't mind checking out that little thing. It's definitely some kind of moon. Nice. I just entered the atmosphere. So this planet was really far away. It was about a max jump away. Obviously, I'm on the other side of the planet, you know, from where my base was, but that's okay. I'm not picking up any signals at this point that indicate that there's any kind of base of operations on this planet. But, oh, dude, look at that mountain. That mountain is huge. I would like to be near that mountain. Inertial dampeners on. Yes, please. Let's fly in that direction. That is such a cool looking... Dude, that thing is huge. I'm not sure what this white stuff is, but I'm guessing some kind of material. Maybe useful. Maybe it's ice. That would be nice. Unintentional rhyme, I swear. Speaking of ice, oxygen's getting a little bit low. I probably should have held on to one of those dudes. But if it gets much lower, I can stop the ship and get out. We have a decent amount of gravity going on right here. But the good news is that I should be all right. It looks like we're getting pretty close to the planet's surface. Kind of coming in for a landing here. I want to hang out right near this giant mountain that I found and this really cool looking kind of ice plane. Inertial dampeners are on. Actual gravity is about one Earth's gravity, a little bit less. You can see it's really more like 0.9, which is cool. Yeah, let's go chill out near this thing over here. Ah, this is neat. We're slowing down, almost stopped. This is cool. Thinking my jump drive's charged. The only downside to a jump drive is it really doesn't work within planetary gravity range. So keep that in mind. You're not going to have the ability to jump away from a planet. You actually have to fly out of the atmosphere before you can jump out. All right, let's go land over in this sunlighty area. There's definitely some kind of minerals or something going on there. This is cool stuff. All right, coming to a stop right about here. Sounds good. I'm guessing that number at the top is my distance from the ground. Nice. Let's bring this little guy for a landing, shall we? Whoa, okay, landing. That was a landing, all right. Probably should have kicked on my shield generator. It's like I'm stuck to the ground. Like, I understand gravity, but, like, suddenly gravity. Like, I had no problems until a second ago, but it's okay. It doesn't look like much by way of damage. I think it was mostly just armor. Right? I didn't lose my inventory, did I? Doesn't look like it. So that's probably good. Let's set up a new station. I need a steel plate block, okay. All right. All right, good news is I can access my steel plates. Aha. I tapped in right there. Good deal. All right, let's get a bit of a platform set up here. Damage doesn't look too bad. I just still haven't figured out why I can't fly it still. I mean, I know it's heavy, but I mean, it just walloped the ground as soon as we got right close to it. Anyway, new station. Let's pop him down right about here. I guess I can't rotate the new station voxel. I thought you could rotate new station voxels, but oh well. I could have sworn you could. There we go. I knew there was a way to do it. New station, you have to hit B to get into rotation mode, and then you can rotate. Nice. So, let's try and flatten this guy out. That looks cool, right? Now, I wouldn't mind doing something like this. So I can at least get up to my connector there.
Low health.
Low health. And I'll get this thing welded up in a minute, obviously, but yeah, that's what I'm talking about. There, now I can access my ship. Ha, cool. I'd really like to know why I couldn't fly this thing. So let me just play around with it a little bit. All right, guys, I started building an atmospheric thruster on that thing. But before I do that and really get that thing off the ground, I wouldn't mind getting a minor base of operations up here. Sweet. Let's get a reactor, just a small basic reactor. It doesn't have to be anything terribly fancy, just so that we've got, you know, basic power up. I wouldn't also mind a medical room. I feel like that would probably be kind of nice to have. That requires interior plates to build. The only reason I want to get this going quickly is just in case anything happens. Number one, I noticed my health was low, and I want to make sure that just in case we have any issues, I can respawn here pretty easily. So I need to build this real quick, be right back. All right, looks like this should be the last bit of welding I need to do for the moment. Nice. So the reactor should be up and running now. If I throw some fuel in there. There we go. Now you can stop complaining about my health being low. Nice. All right, let's see if the atmospheric thruster that I'm throwing on my ship is going to help with the situation. I feel like I'm just having trouble lifting off the ground, and if I got off the ground, then hopefully some of the existing thrusters on the ship would be able to handle it. So let's get cargo, and I need a lot of motors. Believe it or not, that's the thing. There's like 1,100 motors on one of these large atmospheric thrusters. So crazy stuff. Back after I weld it. All right, maybe it'll work. We'll find out in a minute. Let's pop on board here. Oh wow, it is really dark out all of a sudden. Wow, it's still struggling to get off the ground. That's brutal. All right. Well, nothing I can do for that right now. I'm a little bit surprised that it's struggling so much to get off the ground. I mean, obviously we've got some really powerful thrusters here, and they're just like not having any part of it. Maybe just try turning off. I could try turning on inertial dampeners. Nope. Ah, I think I tilted the ship. That's not ideal. There we go. I got it back up. Okay, cool. We flattened out. Cool. But I still can't lift up off the ground. Maybe another one of those large guys. But I think first things first, let's build a Stargate. Let's get this place up and running to the point where I can actually get to and from it without too much of a problem. So, right, more steel plates. I could probably go with some more oxygen and, whoa, hello. I definitely moved the ship a little bit. Whoops. Yes, definitely a little bit moved. Alright, and while we're here, we'll build out another little platform. This should work out pretty well for us. Okay. So, a Stargate. There we go. With an accompanying, and it's really dark, by the way. DHD, probably. Cool. Back in a minute, let me do the welding. All right, let's try this out. Nice. That'll weld up the DHD to full completion. And I think I've got enough resources as well to get the Stargate up and running. And then we can easily get back and forth from our main base to our Mars base. Awesome. All right. Let's name. We'll call this Stargate-Mars Base. And I want to dial Stargate main base. Ready? Cool. Hooray! We made it. Awesome. Now, if we want to dial to the Mars base again, we just do Stargate Mars base. Awesome. That should shut down in a moment, I would expect. And then I can dial it out again. Beautiful. That's what I want to see. All right, guys, really good news. I threw a second atmospheric thruster on there, which you probably can't even see, but it got me off the ground. Nice. Check it out. Whoosh, I can fly again. That is amazing news for me. Hopefully also for you guys, because it means it'll make building a base a little bit easier. Oh, that is much better. Obviously, I don't have great maneuverability on the planet here, but it'll do. It'll definitely do. Ah, oh, that, hey now, what's happening? A little bit hard to navigate. Stop. Alright. Things I just learned. Don't angle the ship downwards. What did I lose? Probably not much. Oh yeah, it's fine. I'm good. Nobody panic. But yes, angling the ship downwards means that all of a sudden the thrusters on the front of the ship are trying to keep it aloft, and haha, they can't. So that's something to keep in mind of. All right, so we've got a decent, I don't even want to say decent. We have a Mars base. Is it a decent Mars base? Probably not. But it's a Mars base nonetheless. Let's turn off the thrusters here, get out, see what kind of damage I might have done to my ship. Oh, we're all right. Oh, right. I've got the shield gen on. Well, that's probably good news. Cool. That'll kill the reactor usage, probably. Yeah. Fuel time, 97 days versus 1 hour. Yeah. Shields are pretty power hungry. But yeah, we're in good shape. Look at that. Oh, nice. So a small little Mars base. Nothing worth writing home about, per se. But you know what? It'll do. It definitely will. Steel plate, huh? There, I have a steel plate now. So two large atmospheric thrusters required to navigate that thing around a little bit. Means I might want to consider rethinking my ship design for planetary usage. So atmospheric thrusters, I presume, will work just fine in the atmosphere, but I doubt that they're going to work very well out in the vacuum of space. Even though there's like no oxygen here, I assume there's some kind of atmosphere because it's a planet after all. So let's go ahead and pop home. And what we're going to do is come back next episode. Back in space. I kind of like space a little bit better than planets at this point. Even though planets are awesome, don't get me wrong, but space is space. I mean, and we don't have to worry about not being able to fly and all the constrictions and pain, but that's all right. We'll be cool. Let's go ahead and plan to come back next episode, and I'm going to explore that Mars-like planet. Hopefully it'll be daytime, which will make exploration a little better. And then I'll also consider working on some basic ship designs in creative mode soon. But it is episode 30, so that means a world download for you guys. Wanted to make sure we got the Mars base at least up and running before the end of the episode, so you had something to play with a little bit. And also, obviously, wanted to make sure that we had you know, everything we could by way of the Stargates working and a ship working and all that good stuff. So for now, Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode. We'll be back next time for more Space Engineer shenanigans. Take it easy, guys.